in Sahih Bukhari. Allahu yu'ati wa anil qasim. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the giver and I am the distributor. So everything that we have is through the wasila and the sadqa of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah is the giver, but the distributor is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and without him distributing it to us, then we would not have it. And he is rahmatul alameen, so he is also the distributor of the mercy of Allah to all of creation. And there are many other things we could say on this, but time gets long, and people that come on time get tired because everybody else comes late. I'm going to ask Mujib to come and recite something for us, inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum. Can everyone please recite their sheaf?
Main Madine chala, main Madine chala, main Madine chala, main Madine chala, phir karam ho gaya, main Madine chala, kaif saancha gaya, main Madine chala, kaif saancha gaya, main Madine chala, chhoomta chhoomta, main Madine chala, chhoomta chhoomta, main Madine chala, main Madine chala, main Madine chala. Mere aqa qadar hoga peshe nazar, mere aqa qadar hoga peshe nazar, chahiye aur kya, main Madine chala, chahiye aur kya, main Madine chala, main Madine chala, main Madine chala. Gumbad-e-sabz par jab paregi nazar, Gumbad-e-sabz par jab paregi nazar, kya surur aayega, main Madine chala, kya surur aayega, main Madine chala, main Madine chala, main Madine chala. Wo bakhi ki zameen jiske andar makin, wo bakhi ki zameen jiske andar makin, mere madni ziya, main Madine chala, mere madni ziya, main Madine chala, main Madine chala, main Madine chala. Unke minar par jab paregi nazar, unke minar par jab paregi nazar, kya surur aayega, main Madine chala, kya surur aayega, main Madine chala, main Madine chala, main Madine chala, phir karam ho gaya, main Madine chala, main Madine chala, main Madine chala.
JazakAllah khair. The poet is basically describing his own condition as he's going toward Medina Munawwara, you know, about the anticipation of seeing Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, and a lot of times we say, you know, we're going to see the rawda of Rasulullah, or the grave of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the blessed grave. But Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that whoever comes to visit my grave, you know, as if he has seen me. And whoever has seen me, he has seen al-haq. Marrani, marrani, faqad ra'a al-haq. You know, and this hadith used to be written on the golden lattice of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the rawda. You know, you also used to have Ya Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam written there, but they added three dots to it recently. Recently meaning, you know, the past, I guess, after the 1970s. So they added three dots, so they changed Ya Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to Ya Majid. And they took this hadith off. You know, because they have no understanding. You know, again, any man who, or any person who has even a little understanding of science understands that the only way you can see something you can't see is through its signs. And the greatest sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, marrani faqad ra'a al-haq. And so again, you know, in this poem, the poet is, you know, he didn't go into this, but the poet is describing his condition as he's going to meet Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Jafar, inshallah, I'm going to ask Jafar to come and recite something for us.
Assalamu alaikum. Everybody, shall do sheaf. Mere Siddique Akbar, Mere Siddique Akbar, Mere Siddique Akbar, Mere Pehla Khalifa, Sadar Sahaba. Aka ka pyara, Siddiq hamara, Nabi ki aankh ke tare, Mere Siddiq ke akbar hai, Sahaba mein bahut pyare, Mere Siddiq ke akbar hai, Nabi ki aankh ke tare, Mere Siddiq ke akbar hai, Sahaba mein bahut pyare, Mere Siddiq ke akbar hai. Baya ho kis zuban se martaba Siddiq Akbar ka, Baya ho kis zuban se martaba Siddiq Akbar ka, Yaare baare mehboob e khuda Siddiq Akbar ka, Nabi ki aankh ke tare, Mere Siddiq Akbar hai, Sahaba mein bahut pyare, Mere Siddiq Akbar hai. Wah teri sadaka Siddiq Akbar, wah teri khilafa Siddiq Akbar, wah teri imamat Siddiq Akbar, wah teri karamat Siddiq Akbar, Nabi ki aankh ke tare, Mere Siddiq Akbar hai, Sahaba mein bahut pyare, Mere Siddiq Akbar hai. Rasulullah Rambiya ke baad jo afzal ho alam se, Rasulullah Rambiya ke baad jo afzal ho alam se, Ya alame hai kiska martaba Siddiq Akbar ka, Nabi ki aankh ke, Nabi ki aankh ke tare, Mere Siddiq Akbar hai, Sahaba mein bahut pyare, Mere Siddiq Akbar hai. Ali hai uska dushman aur wo Ali ka dushman hai, Ali hai uska dushman aur wo dushman Ali ka hai, Jo dushman akal ka dushman hua Siddiq Akbar ka, Nabi ke aankh ke tare, Mere Siddiq Akbar hai, Sahaba mein bahut pyare, Mere Siddiq Akbar hai. Ilahi rahm farma Fatima Siddiq Akbar ho, Ilahi rahm farma Fatima Siddiq Akbar ho, Teri rahmat ke sadqe waasita Siddiq Akbar ka, नबी के आंख के तारे मेरे सिद्दीक़ के अकबर है, सहाबा में बहुत प्यारे मेरे सिद्दीक़ के अकबर है। वह तेरी सदाकत सिद्दीक़ अकबर, वह तेरी खिलाफत सिद्दीक़ अकबर, वह तेरी इमामत सिद्दीक़ अकबर, वह तेरी करामत सिद्दीक़ अकबर। हुए फारूक उस्मान अली जब दाखिल में, हुए फारूक उस्मान अली जब दाखिल में, बना फख्र सनासिल सिलसिला सिद्दीक़ अकबर का। नबी की आंख के तारे मेरे सिद्दीक़ अकबर है, सहाबा में बहुत प्यारे मेरे सिद्दीक़ अकबर है। लताया राह हक में घर कई बार इस मोहब्बत से, लताया राह हक में घर कई बार इस मोहब्बत से, लुत लुत कर हसन घर बन गया सिद्दीक अकबर का। नबी की आंख के तारे मेरे सिद्दीक अकबर है, सहाबा में बहुत प्यारे मेरे सिद्दीक अकबर है। नबी की आंख के तारे मेरे सिद्दीक अकबर है, सहाबा में बहुत प्यारे मेरे सिद्दीक अकबर है।
जज़ाकअल्लाह खैर। Basically, this is manqabat of poetry in honor of Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar, Abu Bakr Siddiq, radiallahu anhu. And, you know, basically the poet is saying, you know, as far as, you know, Siddiq radiallahu anhu being the first Khalifa of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he is loved by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's Nabi ki aankh ke tare, which or literally would be the star of the eye of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but I guess in English terms would be the apple of the eye of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he's loved by the Sahaba, and you know, goes into you know, Abu Bakr radhiyallahu anhu being the companion of the cave of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that he gave everything that he had for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you know, kind of goes into some of the historical aspects of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu being close to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, some of which we'll, I guess, discuss in the talk, inshallah. So I won't go into a lot of details right now. I'm going to ask my father to recite. He's going to tell some things, tell a few things, and then inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum. We are gathered here to learn and talk about one of the closest friends of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about whom he said that there was no secret which came to my heart and it was not transferred to the heart of Hazrat Abu Bakr. He also said that I have paid the favors of everyone else except Hazrat Abu Bakr. His favor was so many that Prophet had to say this, that I could not pay for his favors, you know. And Allah on the day of judgment will pay him. So this is the personality of Hazrat Abu Bakr. Another distinction is that that Ibrahim alayhi salam is the friend of Allah. He has the title of Khalilullah. तो आवाज नहीं आ रही। About Abu Bakr Siddiq, radiallahu ta'ala, Prophet said also that walau kuntu muttakhizan khalila ghaira rabbi lattakhaztu Abu Bakr khalila. If I would have chosen anyone besides Allah as my friend, I would have chosen Abu Bakr Siddiq Radil. That means he is the Khalil. So in my Sheikh, he said in the poetry form, Nisbat Ibrahim ki Siddiq ne paai Aziz. Nisbat Ibrahim ki Siddiq ne paai Aziz, wo Khalil Kibriya hai, ye Khalil Mustafa. Wo Khalil Kibriya hai, ye Khalil Mustafa. And Ibrahim alayhi salam was Khalilullah, and when the angel of death came to him, he said to him, Ibrahim alayhi salam said to him, what a friend who want to take the life of his friend. So the angel of death went back and told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that your friend is saying this, so should I take his soul out or not? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, go back and tell him, what a friend who does not want to meet his friend. So then Ibrahim alayhi salam said, take my soul out, take my soul, I'm ready. So this is the kind of status of friendship between Allah and his prophet. And death is the bridge or which you have to go through to meet your beloved. So death is, in that sense, very beautiful thing, you know. Otherwise, you will never meet your beloved, you know. So this is, and he has got so many titles, you know. Like, he was appreciated and praised by all the companions of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Afzalul Bashr Ba'dul Anbiya, he is the best after Anbiya alayhim as-salam. Yari Ghal, that means he was the companion in the cave. No. Wa'arish, that then he used to fight. The fight will take place. Sahaba Kiram will make a tent for Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to stay in that tent and direct from there, you know. So he and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said to him, he wanted to go and fight too, like in Badr, you know. But he said, Matini binafsika ya Abu Bakr, you stay with me and benefit me with your presence, you know. So Ali radiallahu ta'ala gave him the title of Ashjaun Nas, the bravest man. Because, you know, all the forces and all the enemies, they were trying to hurt Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the one who is going to protect him, he has to be the bravest man, you know. So Ashjaun, he is also Ashjaun Nas. And then he is, you know, also the companion in his resting place, you know. So Yare Ghar, Yare Mazar, Yare Harish. So he has been, that means he has been with him like a shadow all the time. Khalil Razdara, and he was also the secret keeper of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Razdara. And they Khalafat, you know, the first. So all the most of them, Rafiq Mohin Imamat, and he also supported the Imamat of Ali radiallahu ta'ala. He was helping him throughout his time. Well, Rafiq, okay, Khadim Islam, serving Islam, and by service, you become Makhdoom, that means people will serve you. So he is Khadim Islam, and Makhdoom Anam, that means he is the leader of the people, you know. Sahib Hazm Azm Bland, that means he is very powerful, you know, in making decisions and also in bravery, you know. Siddiq wa Sadiq, I want to explain this difference between to you. He had the title of Siddiq as well as of Sadiq. Do you ever hear Sadiq about Abu Bakr Siddiq? He is Siddiq as well as Sadiq. And I'm going to tell you this, but then inshallah 5 minutes, 5 or 10 minutes official. Sadiq or Sadiq. It is narrated in Bible, in Bukhari, and he wrote it in Sahih that there was a kind of dispute about something between Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu ta'ala. Abu Bakr and... So when this news came to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he started chastising Umar radiallahu ta'ala. But Abu Bakr said, no, this is my fault. But even then he continued. And he said this, إِنَّ اللَّهَ بَعَثْنِي إِلَيْكُمْ فَقُلْتُمْ كَذَبَتْ. When Allah SWT sent me to you, you belied me. You refused me. You went against me. وَقَالَ أَبُو بَكْرَ. What Abu Bakr said, صَدَقَ وَعَسَانِي. He said he is truthful, he is saying truth. And he helped me. Bi nafsihi wa malihi, with his own self and with his wealth. Fahal antum tarikuna li sahibi. So you will leave my friend alone? Because he did this. So he says, the word here used is sadaqah. Well, that's why we say sadaqah Allahu wa rasuluhu. Sadaqah Allahu wa sadaqah rasuluhu. Nowadays, it has become only Sadaqallah, Hulalil Azim. That's all. Because they don't want to include Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And as my brother was saying, why? I don't know why. You find out, let me know. Why? If he is not there, we will never reach Allah. He is the medium. He is the wasila. And in Surah Nur, Allah says, that if you follow him, you'll be guided. So the obedience of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the first thing to get the hidayah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah number 24, verse number 54. You can read and make it out. Now, in the other title, which is Siddiq, is derived from and derived by Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. From Surah number 39, Zumar, and verse number 33, where it says, وَالَّذِي جَاءَ بِالصِّدْقِ وَصَدَّقَ بِهِ أُولَٰئِكَ الْمُتَّقُونَ. The one who came with the truth, and the one who testified to it. So this title is from Surah Zumar. Siddiq is from Surah Zumar, or Sadiq is from the hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay, let me then, and you know, in it's kind of sad that some one group, one is Qadi, the other is Shiite and all that, you know. And in Shiite there are two groups, one is Tawallahi, the other is Tabarai. Tawallahi accept the facts of history. They don't, but they like the Imamat of Ali. Fine, he is Imam. We have no dispute. But the other one, which is the Tawarai group, they curse the companions of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That one is the bad one. So remember this, because some Shiites are very kind of, they have kind of normal vision, you know. The others are, they are extreme, you know. So we have to have friendship with the Tawallahi, those who are moderate, but not with the Tabarai. Anyway, like the forefather of his, Janab, the fifth Imam is Imam Janab Muhammad Baqir. Someone asked him that, can we put polish on the sword ऑफ सिल्वर, पॉलिशी कहेंगे ना सिल्वर, देन वी पुट द कोटिंग ऑफ सिल्वर ऑन अवर सोर्स, यू नो. सो ही सेड इट इज अलाउड एंड ही गेव द रेफरेंस दैट हज़रत अबू बकर सिद्दीक रज़ियल्लाहु अन्हु पुट दैट पॉलिश ऑन हिज सोर्ड, सो इट इज अलाउड. Then Bantabarai, you know, as I mentioned, Bantabarai, he heard and he said, to whom he was saying? To Imam Abu, Imam Janab Muhammad Bakr, saying that you also say hey, Abu Bakr Siddiq? So then Imam Bakr, Muhammad Bakr, became kind of furious and kind of full of emotions and said, yes, he is Siddiq, yes, he is Siddiq. And then he raised his hand and said, oh Allah, the one who said, you do not say Siddiq to Abu Bakr, do not make him truthful in this life. So from their own Imams, you know, Abu Bakr Siddiq has a great status in the eyes of Prophet as well as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself. Now, how many of you know the incident when Prophet was immigrating to Medina and Hazrat, who was his companion? Abu Bakr Siddiq, Yari Ghar, the companion in the cave, Ghar Sof. So, and he stayed there 3 days and 3 nights. First of all, during that night, Abu Bakr Siddiq, it was kind of, there are a lot of stories about web and the laying of eggs, you know, by pigeon and all that, you know. But it was kind of a desolated place, you know. It was dark. And I wonder, I did not get the answer for one question. And the answer is there, I know. But from the books, I don't get it. It is totally dark night, 27, totally dark night, and a cave. Do you expect there should be light in the cave? Totally dark outside, inside dark, and Abu Bakr Siddiq enters first to put his life in danger, to clean that cave, you know. This is the kind of companion we are talking about, the Prophet. So, and he goes and clean. Now, how could he see? Because if he would have, I don't know what was that time, matches, it's like match, you know. The enemies of his Prophet will know the light, they could see. And so, it was not kind of tied anywhere. So, he goes in and cleans. And he also sees the holes in the cave wall, you know. And he thinks that there might be something on the other side which come through the holes and hurt my companion, hurt my Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he took the cloth and filled all the holes except one. One was left open. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam laid on his thigh, you know, to take rest. And he put that toe of that leg, you know, against the hole, you know. Knowing that if there is anything on the other side that will come through this hole and I will be hurt. But he, for Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, who was putting his life in danger. And he also said one time that if, like, Jibreel al-Islam, when he came to take the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam for Miraj, ascension, Jibreel al-Islam stopped at Sidratul Muntaha. And he said, oh Prophet, you go now. If I go maybe the width of a hair across this line, all my 600 wings will be burnt, I'll be annihilated. Then Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Abu Bakr, the nature of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu is that he did not care whether his life would be in danger or not. he would not leave the company of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he said, if I would have been there, I would have gone, no matter what. So this is the love for Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So let me just read and the story is like there was a snake, very old snake, maybe hundreds of years old, and he knew the coming of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in that cave. So he was waiting around that cave to get the glimpse of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to see his auspicious face, to see his beauty. And people say that he became prophet at the age of 40. That snake is knowing that he is coming here. So just, you know, make connections, you know, yourself. Now, that snake came. So I read in the poetry, then I explain. Ashuko, the Bukhar, Ashuko, we are also the lover of Prophet, are we not? We are lover of Prophet. So the poet is addressing like this. Aashiqo, jab ghar mein pahunche huzoor, Arsh-e-Azam ban gaya wo farsh-e-noor, aur wahan noor hi noor tha, there was light. Kaise zanwe siddiq par sar ko rakha, so gaye kuch der ko khairul wara. Understand? Don't know Urdu. गए सूए उल्फत न खाए पे चुताब. अब उधर जो सांप था वो उल्फत ने नबी के मोहब्बत ने बस मैच दिस हिज समवन हैज कवर्ड ऑल दीज होल्स एंड देयर इज टू इन दिस. सो एनीवे आशिक बेताब को है इस तरह एंड ही इज गेटिंग मैड. मुद्दतों से मुंतजिर था आज का, तेश भेजा था ना था, तेज भेजा था ना उसका आज का. तो अगर उसका कर रहा था देन इट वॉज राइट फॉर हिम बिकॉज ही वॉज वेटिंग फॉर लॉन्ग. ओके, जान कर दरबान कदम लेने लगा. पहले तो ही थॉट दैट ही इज काइंड ऑफ डो कीपर दरबान. सो ही टुक स्लाइटली नॉडिंग, यू नो, ये शो ऑफ अगेन. तो बलाएं लेना, जैसे यू आर बेगिंग दी वेट की पकड़ी है, लेट मी गो, लेट मी गो. तो ही वाज डूइंग दिस टू फर्स्ट इन ऑफ द टो की खुशामद दे है दो बे इंतहा. बहुत या ट्राई टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड. इस खुशामद पर भी जब मायूस हो या सो हरमा में जो ही महबूस हो, तो ही वाज काइंड ऑफ डिसहार्टेन एंड यू नो क्यों ना करता हो वही कर गुजरे. अब ही वाज नॉट सपोज टू बाइट हिम but now he has no other thing. So he did through that. He beat him with the two of Abu Bakr Siddiq. Okay. So na karte aashiqo aur jo na karta ho ek kar guzre ab aashiqo se aur darma ka adab. Well, there the aashiq one is lover. He could not care for the doorkeeper then. He cares only for beloved. So that's why he beat him. Okay. Dard e furqat ka है गुस्सा कहर मार. एक तो गुस्से में बेट हिम इन व्हेन ही वाज एंग्री एंड देन ही बेट हिम रियल बैड नाउ एंड व्हाट हैपेंड फ्रॉम द आईज ऑफ द क्लियर सी स्टार्टेड शोइंग फ्रॉम द पेन बन गया सोदे रकाबत जहर मार. तो ही पुट द पॉइजन इन देयर. जख्म उठाता है मगर ये पैर ब पैर. नाउ is trying to bear it hard so that Prophet will not be disturbed. Kab hai darbaan Sayyidul Ushaq, he is not a doorkeeper, he is the leader of the lovers. Sayyidul Ushaq, so he does not want to give any kind of trouble to his beloved or disturbance, nothing. So he won't, we were trying that I should not move. But the pain was so bad, you know. And wah wah, kya cheez dil ki chaah hai, sach kaha hai, dil ko dil se raha hai. So he started having pain, and over there the Prophet is also feeling that Abu Bakr Siddiq is suffering. although he tried not to, then आँख खोली सैयदी अबरार ने, राज खोला आशिक के नाचार नाचार ने, then the Prophet woke up and हंस के फरमाया हटा लो अपना पैर, then he is kind of merciful to the snake, you know, so let him come and see. So हंस के फरमाया, the Prophet smiled and told Abu Bakr, move your foot. हंस के फरमाया हटा लो अपना पैर, कर लो अच्छा, अब निकालो अपना पाँव और अपना मूव यू फुट, यू नो, लब लगाते ही इधर आराम था आपने ओके वो मुशरफ हो गया दीदार से स्नेक. He had his purpose, he got his purpose, you know, that he wanted to see the Prophet and he saw him, and you know, and it is said that at the time of leaving this world, Prophet Hazrat Siddiq had the effect of that poison again, and that's how he left. So this is the story. Do you understand? The snake was waiting for Prophet to see him, and there were so many holes, so he Abu Bakr Siddiq filled all the holes with cloth, you know. One was left, he put his foot, and the snake bit him, and Prophet he came to know about it, and he woke up and asked him to move the foot so the snake can see him, you know. So, but Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq was bitten. But first, the snake tried to, you know, kind of politely say that, move your toe. When he did that, got it. And then he had, you know, but Prophet when he put his saliva, everything was gone, clear. So this is the story of that snake. So in everything, when Prophet came, everything was happy, you know, the birds and all creation, except the devil and his followers. They were unhappy, everything was happy, and that's why to become happy when he's coming, his date of coming comes, you know, the birthday, you know. So that's what Eid Milad is. If people object to it, they don't know the meaning of love then, you know. You have to remember your beloved. If you love him, remember him.
Inshallah, we'll make Isha first, since time has started. After Salat, then we'll do the talk, and then Salam, and then eat, inshallah.
Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu anna Muhammadar Rasulullah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadar Rasulullah. Hayya ala salah. Hayya ala salah. Hayya ala falah. Hayya ala fala. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah.